Hello friends, how are you? Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss about the finding of area of some of the polygons, and then later we will calculate and derive the expression for the area of the circle. So we know that the area of a circle is pi r square, okay? And area of a rectangle, we know, is length into breadth, right? L is the length, B is the breadth. And square, area of a square, is side into side, where A is the side. So, today what we will do here is, we will try to find the area of some of the polygons like pentagon, hexagon, and the same concept can be extended to the other polygons having length and number of sides up to n, where n can be any number. And then we will try to convert or converge to calculate the same concept for the area of the circle. So I request everyone of my viewers to please visit and see my previous videos to have the proper understanding about areas of various two-dimensional figures. So let us try to understand and calculate or derive the expression for area of any pentagon. So suppose let us take the example of a pentagon. So pentagon basically is a body which is having five sides, regular five sides. Suppose that is a pentagon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is having the five sides. Okay. And whose each side suppose is of length A, is the length A. Okay. So let us just redraw the diagram and bigger diagram. Suppose I'll make the same figure with some larger area. Suppose that is the pentagon. And then again I will do this thing. So here O is the central point from where each vertices is joined. Suppose vertices A, B, C, D and E. And sides of a pentagon is same, A suppose. So what we'll do here now is, I'll draw a length H. Okay, we know that the area, full area of a circle, suppose this is the full circle. So from side, the whole angle would be 360. So if this is an area, okay, that is a circle. So the full length, or the length of this would be 2 pi r. But the angle is 360, right? So this is 0 degree, that angle is 90, that is 180 degree, that is 270, and again that would be 360, okay? So that angle is 360. Okay. So what would be this angle? If suppose this angle is theta, so that angle theta would be 360 divided by 1, 2, 3, because can be divided by 5. So that would be, and 360 can be written as, that is in degree, and that is another way of writing it in radians, that is 2 pi. So that is in radian, that is another way of writing the angle theta. Okay, so here this theta is if this is the theta angle made by one of the side of length A. Okay, so that angle would be 360 divided by 5, so that is 2 pi by 5. Okay, so now what I should have is to, suppose that is the distance of the vertices from the O. O is the origin. So suppose that distance is X. Okay, that distance is X. So my aim is to find out what is the area of this side. So suppose this is the area I'm interested in. So area of the triangle OCD. OCD. So area of that triangle would be 1 by 2 base into height that we know. And here in this case base is what? Base is this one, the only which is this perpendicular will be drawn, okay? So that is the base and its side length is A, okay? So that is A. Base basically is CD and height is O, suppose that is M. OM, right? So that is OM. So from triangle, suppose there is a triangle OCM. I want to calculate what is this length is. So DC basically is the length C twice of CM, right? There is the CM length. And if it is, if you are familiar with the trigonometric tables on the formula of the trigonometry, then cos theta basically is base upon hypotenuse, and sin theta is basically perpendicular by hypotenuse. Okay, so I will use the same concept. If that is the theta, so what would be this angle then? Then this angle would be theta by 2. Okay, so that is the angle just opposite, side opposite to the angle is basically is the perpendicular, and longest side is the hypotenuse. Then the remaining side would be this one, would be the base. Okay, so in this triangle, in triangle OCM, CM can be find out. First of all, what is sine theta here? Sine phi. Suppose that angle is phi. Okay, and that phi is basically half of this theta angle. Okay, so that would be sine theta by 2. Okay, and sine is perpendicular base, and so perpendicular is this much, which is CM, and hypotenuse is OC, right? So that is sine theta by 2. Okay, so now what we'll do here is we'll calculate what is CM now. So CM would be from here, that would be OC into sine theta by 2, and OC you can see here is x, that is the length x, sine theta by 2, that is CM. So if CM is the length, likewise OM also can be calculated. So OM here is the base, so that would be, base is always calculated in terms of cos theta, so that would be x into cos theta by 2. Likewise we have redrawn or calculated this side OM, right? So now our task is to find the area of this triangle, okay, OCD, OCD, which is the twice OCD, twice of this triangle's area, okay, perpendicular base. So that can be calculated. So suppose now the area of triangle OCD would be half perpendicular base. So perpendicular here is this much, OM, okay, and base is DC, right? But what is DC? DC is twice of CM, right? So that DC is twice of CM, OM, 1 by 2. So that 2 would cancel out. So that would be OM into CM, which we already calculated. What is CM? CM is x into sine theta by 2. So CM in place of CM, OM you can write x into cos theta by 2. Likewise, in place of CM you can write x into sine theta by 2. So the area of triangle here in this case OCD would be this one. So that would be x square sine theta
by 2 cos theta by 2 by 2. So what is the area of a pentagon? Area of pentagon ABCD E would be 5 times of area of triangle OCD. Okay. So that is 5 times of this one. So 5 times x square into cos theta by 2 into sin theta by 2. Okay.
So what we'll do here is we'll just now try to use one of the property of our trigonometric table. So one of the properties, sine 2 theta is actually 2 sine theta by 2 into cos theta, this much. Okay. And if it is sine theta, then this would be sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. So whatever the angle here is, so this angle would be half of this angle. Okay. So I will use this property. And we know that what we have calculated is the area of pentagon here in this case. Pentagon here is 5 into x square into sine theta by 2 cos theta by 2. I am just applying this formula here. So that would be 5 times of divide by 2 and then I multiply with 2 to sine theta by 2 and cos theta by 2. So when I will apply this formula, so that would make the sine theta. So that would be 5 by 2 of x square into sine theta. Where theta is the angle of the of one of the side of the pentagon. So that is the pentagon. Okay. So one of the side makes an angle with the center point. So that angle is theta, right? So if you know what is the distance of the one of the vertices from the center of the regular figure, so you can just use that kind of formula. So the area of regular pentagon we have calculated is 5 by 2 into x square into sine theta, where theta is the angle made by one of the side of the pentagon from the center of the pentagon. So there is the pentagon. Okay, so this angle basically is the theta, right? So if you know what is the angle theta, so and we know that regular pentagon has a side of small a, so you can just replace the value of theta and x in terms of r to calculate this thing. So you know that x is what? So this can be written as, we know is, we can replace it by basically by any of the thing. So this x can be written as, because you know that if it, this is the side which is a, so that would be a by 2. So just a by 2 is the, this is the angle which is theta by 2. So a by 2 divided by hypotenuse which is x should be equal to, that is a perpendicular back, so that should be sine theta by 2. Okay, so x from here can be written as a by 2 divided by sine theta by 2. That's very simple. So x square can be written as a square by 4 divided by sine square theta by 2. Okay, so likewise sine theta can be replaced as, sine theta can be written as 2 sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. So you know that sine theta by 2 is nothing but so basically you just put this value here, so that will be 5 by 2 of x square is a square by 4 divided by sine square theta by 2. Okay, and this can be written as 2 sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. I am using the same formula for this one. So
some of these things would cancel out. So 2 would be cancelled out, that is 5 divided by this one, 4 a square, okay. And one of the sign would be cancelled out, so that would be cos theta by 2 divided by sin theta by 2. So one of the sign would cancel out, and that would be this. That would be cot theta by 2 to a square 5 by 4. So now what you can do here is, you can just find the value what is cot theta by 2. So if this is, that is theta by 2, so cot theta by 2 basically is the base by perpendicular that we know. Okay. So base is, if this is this, then the base this will be this, if this is the edge, and base is perpendicular a by 2. So you can put this value here and then you can find out. Okay. So basically this is the way we can calculate the area of a regular pentagon. So the same concept would be applied to find out the area of the hexagon. So let us see how can we do it. So suppose there is the hexagon. So a regular hexagon basically is like this, or look like this. Okay. And again, suppose there is a center O, and we will try to find out what is the area of this hexagon. So again, we will do here is, we will just do like this, and this suppose is the x, is the distance of the vertices from the center O of the hexagon. Suppose hexagon has the vertices A, B, C, D, E and F. Okay. So again, the area of this triangle, okay, suppose there is O, C, D. So area of triangle OCD basically is the area of triangle OCM, and which is multiplied by 2. Okay, so if you multiply this area by 2, that will be this. So what is the angle subtended by this triangle? Suppose that angle is theta. Again, the same concept we are applying. Suppose there is O and there is D and C. Okay, and there is a perpendicular which is M. So if this whole angle is theta, so this angle would be theta by 2. Okay. Very simple. So what we'll do here is, we'll just try to write the formula for area of this triangle. So that is perpendicular 1 by 2 base into height, and base is this one. This whole is A, so base is A by 2. And let us just write in terms of base, suppose is into height, okay, perpendicular. So base here is this one. If it is x, okay, so this base would be x into sine theta by 2. And likewise, this is the perpendicular, which is h, it would be x into cos theta by 2. Okay, very simple. So you can just put this value here. So that would be base is 2 would be cancelled out. So that is base into height only. Okay. So here base is OC, base is MC into OM, right? And we know that MC here is x into cos sin theta by 2, and this is x into cos theta by 2, theta by 2. So that would make x square sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. Again, we are applying the same formula, so that can be written as x square by 2 into 2 twice of sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2, and which would be equal to sin theta. So that is x square by 2 sin theta. So that is the area of this particular triangle. That we know that in a regular hexagon there are six number of such triangles. Okay. So the area of hexagon now here is hexagon A, B, C, D, E and F would be 6 times of this area. Okay. So area of triangle OCD. So that is 6 times of x square by 2 into sin theta. Okay. So that can be written as 3 times of x square sin theta. Very simple. Okay. So the area of hexagon in this case would be thrice of x square sin theta. Okay. So what we know here is, what is the value of x? So if you know in a hexagon regular hexagon, this x is basically parallel to DC. Similarly, this is parallel to this one. So these two should be same. If it is A, so your x should be A. Okay, so x here is basically the side of the hexagon. So that can be replaced as 3 into A square into sin theta, and this sin theta can be as sin theta by 2 and cos theta by 2 twice again. So that would be 3 by 2, 3 basically, 3 of A square, and that can be done A into, twice into sin theta by 2 and cos theta by 2. Again, this can be replaced with the help of x and y, and x can be replaced by A. So just, you know that sin theta by 2, in that case, sin theta by 2 would be this one, MC, okay, divided by hypotenuse, which is x. So MC here is A by 2, and x, again, we know that x is A, we already know it, so that could be 1 by 2, because A is cancelled, also 1 by 2 would remain. So likewise, cos theta can be calculated. Cos theta by 2 would be again hypotenuse by this one. So hypotenuse can also be calculated by just doing it. We know that the hypotenuse means this triangle. Hypotenuse is h. This is the triangle, okay? Where this is h, and this is OM, and that is C. So that is basically hypotenuse. So a hypotenuse here, plus this one, which is A by 2, okay, so A by 2's whole square would be this one, which is x, okay, and this x itself is A, you know it, A square, so that h square would be A square minus A square by 4, so that h would be root 3 by 2 of A, okay, so that would be h, so you can just put this value here, so cos theta by 2 is h upon hypotenuse x, so h is nothing but root 3 by 2, A. We already calculated, and x is A, so that would make root 3 by 2, that's all. So here this would be, so area of hexagon would be 3 times of A square twice, and sin theta by 2 we have calculated is 1 by 2, and cos theta by 2 is root 3 by 2, so that 2 would cancel out. So that is very simple, 3 times of root 3, okay, divided by 2 of A square. So that is basically the area of the regular hexagon. Okay. So the same concept we will try to apply for calculating the area of a circle. So in generalize, if you try to generalize this concept, what is the area of a polygon? Polygon is a regular figure where the sides are n in numbers. Okay. Polygon, poly, many sides. Okay. So area of a polygon, in terms of a polygon, it means many sides. So the area should be, I mean, in this way, in this fashion can be written as area of a polygon can be written as x square, okay, and n times, because you have to multiply with n, okay, then sine theta, theta is basically 2 pi by n, 2 pi by n, and you have to divide it by n, okay, so divide by 2, similarly sine, that is cos 2 pi by n into 2. Why I'm dividing? Because theta here is 2 pi by n, right, but here it was sine theta by 2, you already calculated, so I have to divide it by 2 here, okay, so likewise here, because if a polygon is there, many sides are there, suppose like this, polygon is there, okay, something like that, so one of the side is A, okay, and this angle is theta, so you will perpendicular, draw the perpendicular here, so that angle would be theta by 2, okay, so again we are applying the same formula, 2 would cancel out, so that is the generalized formula we already have calculated, so we will not go in detail because we already have done it, so that would be n times of x square into sin theta by 2 to cos theta by 2. So in general that can be written as n into x square into sin 2 pi, not 2 pi, but pi by n, that's the only thing we mean, pi by n into cos pi by n, right? So that is in general we will find the formula. So let us try to apply the same concept
to calculate the area of a circle. Okay, so in case of a circle, so circle is something like that. Okay, we know it.
And suppose that is the center of the circle, and this circle is made of many polygons, of a polygon of having many sides like this. I'm trying. Okay, something like that. And is separated by some distance, something like that. So that polygon, okay, simple. So here, this vertices from the center is of length x, okay. So let us replace this x with r, because r is the radius of the circle. So that distance is r, okay. And we know that the area of this polygon, okay, or the circle, in general, polygon, area of a polygon we know is first of all area of this one, this triangle. So that is this is x, and this angle, if the that is the this segment, okay, this one, this segment. So that angle is theta. So I am drawing a perpendicular from here. So the that is AB, and there is M. So that is AB, and that is M, and this is a perpendicular. So this angle would be theta by 2, okay. And if it is R, suppose that is R, so area of this would be 1 by 2 base into height. So base is this one, so that is my angle theta by 2, so that should be sine theta by 2. So R into sine theta by 2, and likewise this, that would be R into cos theta by 2, right. So that would be 1 by 2 R square sine theta by 2 to cos theta by 2. So that is the area of this side. So area of this triangle, we double up this one, so just you will multiply by 2, okay. So the area of triangle, this one, triangle OAB would be this one. So 2 would cancel out, so R square into sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. But there are n number of such triangles, so you have to multiply it by n, okay. So that is the area of the polygon, we already know. So that would be n into R square into sine theta by 2 into cos theta by 2. So that basically makes the area of a polygon. So what is the speciality of a circle? The speciality is that this n here is infinite, because number of triangles, because you have to create small segments, okay. So basically number of triangles, number of polygons, or the sides of a polygon in case of a circle can be considered as infinity. So as n goes infinity, so this angle would become smaller and smaller. This angle basically would become smaller and smaller, because the triangle would become smaller, so that theta would go to 0. So that is the special limit we will put here. That is the limit we will put while we are trying to calculate the area of the polygon. So what is the limitation? What is the effect of that limit? So when you will put the limit, n goes to infinity or theta goes to 0, sine theta would be equal to theta. There is a product or the result of that limit. Similarly, if you put the limit n goes to infinity or theta goes to 0, the same thing, the cos theta would basically equal to 1. That is the limit we will use and try to find out the area of the circle. Okay, so the area of the circle can be calculated in this fashion. So area of circle now would be area of polygon, which is n into r square to sine theta by 2 to cos theta by 2, okay. And we'll put the limit n goes to infinity, or you can say theta goes to 0. So this can be replaced as n by 2 into r square, so that is 2 into sine theta by 2 into cos theta, we already know it. So that would make sine theta by 2. So that is n by 2 into r square to sine theta. Okay, that would be. And what is the limit? Limit is n goes to infinity or theta goes to 0. Okay, so that limit would be applied for this one. So you can take n by 2 and r square common, because these are the constants. And then you will put the limit n goes to 0 here in case of sine theta. So that would become only theta would come out. times, okay?
So this can be written as n by 2 into r square into theta. What is theta then? We already know that theta is what? Theta is the angle subtended by this side on the center of the circle. So this theta would be whole angle of the circle, which is 2 pi 360 and divide by the number of sides, which is n. Okay, so theta is nothing but 2 pi by n. So you can put this value here. Okay, so that would be n by 2 into r square into 2 pi by n. So you can see here is that n would be cancelled out. This 2 would go. So only pi r square would remain. So that is the area of the circle. So that is basically area of the circle is the limiting case of the area of a polygon. Okay, so that we have learned. So the area of a circle can basically be found out by the same concept we have used in calculating the area of a polygon. Okay, so area of circle is in this way we have calculated is pi to r square. So thank you very much for watching the videos. I am signing off. I hope this video would be very helpful and to understand and remember the concept and the basic principle to find the area of any two-dimensional regular figure. So we applied the same principle to find the area of many figures like square, rectangle, circle, polygon, pentagon, okay, and hexagon likewise. So and by the same principle we arrived to find out the area of the circle. So I hope this video would be liked by all, and I request my viewers to please see my previous videos to make the concept good, so that the concept would be on the fixed grounds. And if you like the video, please click on the like button, and if you like my channel, please subscribe the channel. I'm signing off. Thank you for watching the video.